Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. Today the topic of our discussion is an amazing topic in biology, that is the difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic translation. Please watch till the end for complete understanding. Let's begin with the definition. For better understanding, let us begin with the central dogma of biology. As we all know, all information that is required for the synthesis of all proteins inside the cells are coded on the genetic material, DNA. Suppose this is the DNA strand and this is the sequence. First, this DNA is transcribed to mRNA. So, one of the strand is used as a template for the synthesis of this complementary strand, mRNA strand. So, we have mRNA. The formation of mRNA from DNA template strand is called as transcription. The next process, this mRNA, the information on mRNA is used to synthesize amino acids of protein. Let's take this example. This AUG is a triplet codon that codes for amino acid methionine. Or in simple terms, translation is a process by which the sequence of bases of mRNA is converted to sequence of amino acids of a protein. As you can see here, AUG codes for methionine, GGG codes for glycine, etc. So it is simply an mRNA dependent synthesis of protein. Now let us look into the difference between eukaryotic and prokaryotic translation in detail. Difference number one, regarding the site of transcription and translation. In the case of prokaryotes, as you can see, here this green line, transcription is happening, and along with transcription, translation has already begun. So, transcription and translation are coupled in prokaryotes. Both can occur simultaneously, and the location is cytoplasm. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, transcription takes place inside nucleus. Here mRNA is formed, it is processed, it comes out through nuclear pore into the cytoplasm where translation occurs. So here translation and transcription is not coupled, it occurs in different site. Transcription occurs in nucleus, whereas translation occurs in cytoplasm. Difference number two, regarding mRNA for protein synthesis. In the case of prokaryotes, as translation and transcription are coupled, there is little mRNA processing. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, there is extensive mRNA processing. The mRNA is with both exons and introns. Exons are the coding sequences or expressing sequences, whereas introns are non-coding sequences. The first step is the removal of introns or non-coding sequences and joining of exons. Then the second processing is the addition of 5' cap, which is a chemical 7-methyl guanosine. And the third step is the addition of poly A tail, which is approximately 200 adenine residues at the 3' end of the mRNA. So this processed mRNA comes out through the nuclear pore into the cytoplasm, then translation begins. So there is extensive mRNA processing in the case of eukaryotes. Difference number three, regarding transcriptional unit. In the case of prokaryotes, mRNA is polycistronic. That means mRNA has information for information or coded information for the synthesis of many proteins under a single control. As you can see here, three proteins named alpha, beta and gamma are coded on the same mRNA under a single control. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, mRNA is monocistronic, whereas mRNA has information for a single protein. So it has information for the synthesis of a single protein under a single control. That's why it is called as mono single cistronic. Difference number four, regarding the ribosomes involved. In the case of prokaryotes, 70S ribosome is involved. It consists of two subunits, a 50S larger subunit and 30S smaller subunit, making a complete 70S ribosome. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, it is 80S ribosome. It consists of two subunits, a larger 60S subunit and a smaller 40S subunit, making an 80S ribosome. We have given a detailed video on 70S and 80S ribosome, and you can refer that for more information. Now, translation can be divided into three steps: initiation, elongation, and termination. Difference number 5 is regarding the translation initiation. During translation initiation, ribosome small subunit binds to a specific sequence on mRNA, which is called as Schein-Dalgarno sequence in prokaryotes. As you can see, this is the 30S subunit, and a part of 30S subunit is 16S rRNA, which is having a complementary sequence to that of Schein-Dalgarno sequence to which it forms hydrogen bond. So this is the pairing. Once 30S subunit finds this SD sequence, it scans and finally reaching this start codon. SD sequence is 8 nucleotides upstream of the start codon AUG. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, the 43S pre-initiation complex that comprises of small subunit 40S, then initiation factors along with charged tRNA that binds to the 5' cap of mRNA with the help of many initiation factors. Then it moves in 5', 3' direction and finally finds the start codon AUG. So in eukaryotes, initial small ribosome subunit binding site is 5' cap, 7-methylguanosine cap of mRNA. I would like to add one more point. There's a sequence which is called as Cossack sequence in eukaryotes. As you can see, this is a sequence. You can see start codon within this Cossack sequence. Cossack sequence, the presence of Cossack sequence favors efficient initiation and translation process. But remember, it has nothing to do with initial binding of ribosome small subunit. Ribosome small subunit 40S always binds to the 5', 7-methylguanosine cap of mRNA. Difference number 6 regarding initiator tRNA. Once both the small subunit and large subunit are joined on the mRNA, there is an A site which is called as aminoacyl site, then there is a P site and there is an exit site. An AUG is the start codon, and the initiator tRNA that recognizes this start codon in prokaryotes is formulated, or it is 4-methionyl tRNA, as you can see, FMET. Initiation codon, as always, AUG codes for methionine. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, initiator tRNA is methionyl tRNA. It is not formylated. Difference number 7 regarding the translation initiation factors involved. As you can see, this is a process that is actually happening during the initiation process. The binding of small subunit to the mRNA in the SD sequence, and followed by the binding of charged tRNA. After that, the large subunit comes and binds to the small subunit. And this is a process that is happening during initiation. So during initiation in prokaryotes, three initiation factors are involved. So large subunit should bind only after the formation of this complex, small subunit, mRNA and tRNA complex. So initiation factor actually guides proper association of ribosomal subunits during initiation. Initiation factor 1 binds to this small subunit 30S subunit and prevents premature entry of tRNA to A site. Whereas IF2 GTP, initiation factor 2 GTP, helps in binding of FMET tRNA to 30S ribosomal subunit. Whereas initiation factor 3 binds to 30S subunit and prevents premature binding of 50S subunit. IF3 ensures that 50S subunit can bind only after the formation of this 30S initiation complex. and finally forming the 70S initiation complex. Whereas in eukaryotes, the process is extremely complex and involves approximately 12 initiation factors. Let us discuss the function of one or two. Eukaryotic initiation factor 1 and 1A both binds to 40S ribosome subunit mRNA complex. Then EIF2 is involved in delivering initiator methionyl tRNA to P site, just like IF2, and there are many other eukaryotic initiation factors that properly guides the association of small and large ribosomal subunits for the translation to begin. Difference number 8 regarding the elongation factors involved. As you can see, this is a process that is happening during elongation. Charged tRNA with amino acid enters the A site, and the second step is the formation of peptide bond. Then the empty tRNA moves to the exit site and that is released. So in prokaryotes, there are 4 elongation factors. First one is EFTU, that brings aminoacyl tRNA to A site of the ribosome. This is aminoacyl tRNA, activated tRNA. EFTU brings this tRNA to the A site, which is having an anticodon corresponding to the code of the mRNA. Then EFTS is involved in recycling this EFTU. And EFG is involved in translocation. So this is the translocation process. As you can see, EFG is the protein that is involved in translocation. So as you can see, this delivery of aminoacyl tRNA occurs to the A site, then it forms peptide bond in P site, then the empty tRNA is released from the exit site. During this process, mRNA is pulled through ribosome by a codon or by 3 nucleotides, and that process is called as translocation. And EFG is the elongation factor involved in translocation, and EFP is involved in peptide bond synthesis between these two amino acids. In the case of eukaryotes, there are similar analogs. As you can see, 4 elongation factors. There is eukaryotic elongation factor 1 alpha that is bringing this aminoacyl tRNA to the A site of the ribosome. Then there is elongation factor 1 beta gamma that is involved in recycling this EF1 alpha. Then EF2 is involved in translocation, whereas EIF5A that is involved in the formation of peptide bond between amino acids in the P site. Difference number 9 regarding the translation termination and the release factors involved in termination process. When the ribosome reaches the stop codon, there is no tRNA that can recognize the stop codon. So specific proteins called release factors can recognize this stop codon, and it binds to the stop codon. Then the first thing happens is this release factor hydrolyzes the bond between the tRNA in the P site and the last amino acid of the polypeptide chain, or simply it cleaves the peptide bond, releasing the formed polypeptide chain, and then finally causing the disassembly of the entire complex, releasing small subunit, large subunit, mRNA and all other proteins involved. In the case of prokaryotes, 3 release factors are present: RF1 that is capable of recognizing stop codons UAA and UAG, whereas RF2 is a release factor for stop codons UAA and UGA, and RF3 facilitates binding of RF1 and RF2 to the ribosome. In the case of eukaryotes, there is only 1 release factor that can recognize all 3 stop codons. And finally, post-translational modification, difference number 10. In the case of prokaryotes, there is relatively low number of post-translational modification in comparison with eukaryotic proteins. It occurs in cytoplasm. First amino acid, that is the formylmethionine, is removed in prokaryotes. Whereas in the case of eukaryotes, there is extensive post-translational modification as there are many membrane-bound organelles designed for the purpose, like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, etc. Endoplasmic reticulum is a site of glycosylation, then disulfide bond formation. Golgi apparatus is also the site of glycosylation. So there is extensive post-translational modification of the formed polypeptide before becoming a functional protein in the case of eukaryotes. Thank you so much for your attention. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.